बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल डॉक्टर आबिद सरगानी। फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक, दैट इज मेथड्स ऑफ मीट प्रिजर्वेशन। सो लेट अस डिस्कस दैट व्हाट आर द मोस्ट कॉमन मेथड्स ऑफ द मीट प्रिजर्वेशन। देर आर सेवरल मेथड्स व्हिच आर यूज्ड टू प्रिजर्व द और कंजर्व द क्वालिटी ऑफ द मीट एंड सेफ्टी। नंबर वन इज चिलिंग, फ्रीजिंग, क्योरिंग, स्मोकिंग, थर्मल प्रोसेसिंग, कैनिंग, ड्राइंग एंड इरेडिएशन। दीज आर सेवरल मेथड्स व्हिच विल बी डिस्कस्ड इन डिटेल वन बाय वन। बट बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द मेथड्स ऑफ द प्रिजर्वेशन, वी शुड नो दैट व्हाट आर द कॉमन फैक्टर्स व्हिच अफेक्ट्स द क्वालिटी ऑफ मीट एंड इट्स टेंडरनेस। नंबर वन इज इंट्रिंसिक फैक्टर which influence the quality of meat is includes the species, breed or crossbreed, genotype, age, gender and weight at the time of slaughter also influences the quality of meat. Number second is extrinsic factor. Pre-slaughter extrinsic factors includes the management, stress agents and the behavior of animal and diet of the animal before slaughtering, just like milk or milk replacer, weaning diet and chemical composition and physical status of the meat also influences the quality of meat. And production system in which animal is raised also have a great importance on the meat quality. And pre-slaughter conditions at the lairage also influences the quality of meat. Intra and post-slaughtering factors, these are also extrinsic factors which influences the quality of meat. These includes the slaughtering method and the loss of blood or bleeding, storage conditions of the meat, aging of the meat, type of conservation, commercialization and consumption of the meat, manner and time of the cooking and consumers' habits. These also influence the quality of the meat. Now the meat quality is reduced by the time through the digestive enzymes which causes the proteolysis, lipolysis, etc. and the fat oxidation and microbial spoilage due to the neutral pH and high moisture content of the meat. This is because, as we know, that microbial growth occurs mainly at the neutral pH and high moisture contents. So this facilitates the more to the microbes to grow and causing the spoilage and degeneration of the muscles, tissues and affects the tenderness of the meat. So what are the aim of meat preservation? Number one is to maintain the safety and quality of the meat for a prolonged period of time and maintain its tenderness and palatability, which attracts the consumers and prevent from the spoilage. Last, to enhance the shelf life of the meat. These are the common aims of the meat preservation. Number one method is the chilling or refrigeration of the meat. Chilling of the meat is done at the temperature of 4 degrees centigrade or up to the 10 degrees centigrade is recommended, but mostly occurs at 4 degrees centigrade. This method is applied for the short-term preservation of the meat because it slows down the microbial growth and enzymatic activities. There are two methods of the chilling. Number one is immersion chilling, in which the meat product is immersed in chilled water. While in air chilling, the carcass is misted with water in a room with circulating chilled air. Freezing is another method of the meat preservation. This is applied for the long-term preservation because it stops the microbial growth and enzymatic activity of the meat. It is done at minus 18 degrees Celsius. Temperature of the freezing may be variable depending upon the storage time required for how much we are going to store that product. Shelf life of the frozen meat at minus 18 degree Celsius. It depends upon the type of meat. First one is mutton, chivon, beef and kara beef or the buffin can be kept for 6 months without changing or damaging their qualities or the properties of the meat. And pork and chicken meat can be preserved for 4 months at minus 18 degrees centigrade. And cured and salted meat is to be preserved for 2 months. This is an equipment called automatic frozen meat packaging machine, which is used to not only the froze but also packaging the meat products. Number second is curing method. This is also an other method of the meat preservation in which various products or the chemical agents like salt, sugar, nitrate and nitrates are applied over the meat to reduce their water content, moisture and inhibit the microbial growth. The permissible level of the nitrate is 500 parts per million, while nitrite is 200 parts per million. This is recommended. This is one of the oldest method of the meat preservation. Smoking is another method of the meat preservation in which smoke is used to develop the flavor, aroma and color in the meat. There are two methods of the smoking. Number one is cold smoking at a temperature of around 26 to 43 degrees centigrade. And second one is hot smoking, which is done at 71 to 79 degrees Celsius. Thermal processing is another method of the meat preservation. There are two methods of the thermal processing. One is pasteurization method and second is sterilization method. In pasteurization method, there are other several methods which are applied over the meat to preserve their qualities. Number one is high pressure pasteurization, hot water, steam, hot air, infrared heat, radio frequency and irradiation methods, in which hot water, steam and HPP are the most popular methods of the meat preservation through the pasteurization. And while in sterilization, method of the thermal processing of meat is done through the microwave sterilization equipment, in which thermal sterilization and drying of the meat products occur simultaneously. Canning. This is another method of the meat preservation in which sterilization of product is done in thermetically sealed container at around 121 degree centigrade. Temperature may be reduced if pressure is increased in the meat container. Another method most commonly used is drying method. This is one of the oldest methods applied over the meat to preserve their qualities and tenderness. Drying is the removal of water from the meat up to around 15% from the 70% of the water content in the meat. It's done through two methods. One is artificial dehydration by using the dehydrating trays, as you are watching on the screen. This is a dehydrating trays in which air applied and the circulated pellet which dries the meat. Number second is natural sun drying. This is also one of the oldest methods of the meat preservation, usually nowadays also applied in the deep rural areas of the developing countries. Irradiation is an important method of the or the technical method of meat preservation, which is practiced by using gamma rays. Gamma rays are the cheapest and most frequently used in the preservation. So the gamma rays are obtained from the isotopes like cobalt and cesium, which are used to irradiate the meat. Irradiation processing plant is somewhat like this, which have the developed and modernized through the concrete walls, transport mechanism, radioactive material and water pool, and sliding rotating concrete doors. This is completely environmentally controlled to prevent from the environmental degradations. Thank you very much. Today's lecture was all about this. Thank you. Hopefully you will enjoy this video. And if you have any queries, you may ask regarding this lecture in comment box. Thank you very much.